So what occurs with frontier orbitals of the nanoparticles? Here are frontier orbitals of bare nanoparticles. So as we can see, HOMA have dominating contributions from either selenium or tellurium centers, and LUMA has very high contributions from cadmium centers. Okay, so here are HOMAs and LUMAs for the capped nanoparticles. As we can see, HOMAs of the capped nanoparticles have dominating contributions again from the nanoparticle centers, and really small contributions from the ligands. LUMAs of the capped species, capped nanoparticles, have significant contributions from the nanoparticle centers, and also large contributions from ligands. So we can say that, and also these shifts of HOMAs and LUMAs on the energy scale tell us that both NH3 and OPH3 groups cause noticeable destabilization of HOMA and LUMA orbitals, which is more pronounced for the LUMA orbitals. So the question is, what happens when nanoparticles are kept with SCH3 groups? Situation is drastically different in this case. So these are structures computed for SCH3 capped nanoparticles. We obtained both so-called closed nanomers, closed species and open species, which are usually which were found to be lower in energy than these closed species by 5.2 kilocalories per mole in the gas phase for cadmium selenide and cadmium telluride respectively. So as we can see, the structure of the original species is very strongly distorted. Also, we found that that energy gaps between singlets and triplets in SCH3 capped nanoparticles are significantly smaller than for the bare nanoparticles. So we can conclude that there is so strong interplay between surface chemistry or the ligands and nanoparticle structure. We observe bridge formations between nanoparticle atoms, like in this case, for instance, and also numerous breakages of cadmium selenide and cadmium telluride bonds, significantly pronounced opening of nanoparticles. And here is the situation with HOMAs and LUMAs of SCH3 capped nanoparticles. SCH3 groups destabilize HOMAs of capped nanoparticles, but stabilize the LUMAs. So we see the situation is different from the case of NH3 and OPH3 capped nanoparticles. Also, what we can see that now contributions into HOMAs and LUMAs of SCH3 capped nanoparticles are different from the case of NH3 and OPH3 capped species. We see significant contributions from nanoparticle centers, but only from some of them, also contributions from the ligand. And in the case of the LUMA, there are some contributions from nanoparticle atoms and significant contributions from ligands. So now the question is, what about large nanoparticles, cadmium-9, selenium-9, or cadmium-9, tellurium-9? So here was the global minimum structure which we found for bare cadmium-9, X9 nanoparticles. It was found to have D3H symmetry. And again, triplets were found to be very high in energy. Same case like for smaller nanoparticles. So what happens when they are kept with NH3 groups? Now we can see that some distortions of the nanoparticle structure occur compared to the case of cadmium-6, selenium-6 or cadmium-6, tellurium-6 nanoparticles. And still single triplet energy gaps are very high, even higher than for the bare nanoparticle. And situation in the case of OPH3 capping is even worse. Worse regarding the retaining of the geometry of the original nanoparticle. Now nanoparticle cores are very strongly distorted compared to the bare species. And also what we can see, there are, for instance, proton transfers from OPH3 groups to nanoparticle centers, like here. So not only the structure of the nanoparticle core changes, but also chemical nature of the capping group changes due to proton transfers from PH3 groups to the nanoparticle core. Yes, and this is one line conclusion that significant distortions upon capping by all groups are observed. So these are situations with frontier orbitals of NH3 and OPH3 capped nanoparticles. Again, as we can see, in the case of NH3 capping and OPH3 capping, both HOMOS and LUMOS of capped species have significant contributions from the core, and some contributions from the ligands, small contributions from the ligands in the case of HOMA, and large contributions from the ligands in the case of LUMA. And both NH3 and OPH3 groups noticeably destabilize both HOMA and LUMA of the capped nanoparticles, more pronouncedly for the LUMA, for the LUMAs. So what happens when nanoparticles are kept with SCH3 groups? First of all, again, we have significant distortion of nanoparticle structures. But if we compare them if we compare capped nanoparticles with OPH3 capped species, we can see that in the case of SCH3, nanoparticle core is not that significantly distorted. Also, it's interesting to notice that with 9 SCH3 ligands, we have doublet ground states. Not ground states. We have either doublet or quartet ground states for these nanoparticles. And as we can see from these numbers, energy differences between doublet and quartet states are really small. So actually, in the gas phase, it was shown that quartets are slightly lower in energy, but for simplicity's sake, we decided to consider doublets in our studies. And again, if you compare single triplet energy splitting for the bare nanoparticle, we see drastic changes. So, and what about frontier orbitals? Again, as in the case of smaller capped nanoparticles, we can see that HOMAs of the capped nanoparticles are destabilized, but the LUMAs are significantly stabilized. Yeah, this is summarized again in this line. Okay, now let us go through conclusions. So the conclusions of this study. First conclusion is that first systematic DFT study of the structural and electronic properties of small cadmium selenide and cadmium telluride nanoparticles, both bare and capped with amino, cyan, and phosphine oxide ligands was performed. It was found that ammonia and OPH3 groups perturb the structures of cadmium 6X6 nanoparticles, but not significantly. For SCH3 capping, however, bridge formations between nanoparticle atoms, breakage of cadmium selenide and cadmium telluride bonds, and opening of nanoparticles was observed. Both NH3 and OPH3 groups were shown to cause noticeable homo-LUMO destabilization in capped nanoparticles, which is more pronounced for the LUMOs than for the HOMOs. SCH3 groups were shown to destabilize HOMOs of capped nanoparticles and stabilize their LUMOs. And in the case of larger nanoparticles, cadmium 9X9, it was shown that all of them, for all three ligands, they undergo quite significant distortions. And similar trends in stabilization and destabilization of frontier orbitals and homo-LUMO gap changes were observed in comparison with the capped cadmium 6X, cadmium 6X6 nanoparticles. Questions will follow after the whole presentation. Mm. Okay. Yeah, and here are acknowledgments to my co-authors and to the sources of financial support of this study. And now I would like to proceed to our follow-up study, where we considered effects of sulfur-containing ligands on the structure and electronic properties of small nanoparticles, cadmium selenide and cadmium telluride nanoparticles, where total number of atoms varied from 6 to 18. So this paper is just recently accepted. Computational details are as follows. We used capping groups with carboxyl groups and ammonia groups, and with different lengths of capping ligands. We studied geometries, electronic structures, ligand binding, and optical properties absorption spectra of these capped nanoparticles, both in the gas phase and with solvent effects from water and toluene taken into account. And we compared results obtained for capped nanoparticles with results obtained for bare nanoparticles. Calculations were performed using the same approach as in our previous study, and we used a later version of Gaussian software, Gaussian 09. So here are results in a nutshell. I will not go in too many details because it would take quite a long time. So these are structures of bare nanoparticles which were studied. So as we can see, cadmium 3X3 nanoparticles are flat. Cadmium 4X4 nanoparticles are formed of two interpenetrating tetrahedra, and here are already familiar structures of cadmium 6X6 and cadmium 9X9 nanoparticles. So what happens when they are kept with these three ligands?
Mm-hmm.